Hello everyone, today I'm going to teach you how to make a very basic Animation Now video using Wonder Media's StoryMaker program. To begin, let me introduce and explain the main programs that you'll be using to create your video. Audacity is where you will record your voice or edit sound clips. Adobe Premiere is where you can edit video clips for post-production. DaVinci's Resolve is another program that you can use to edit your videos. The red, green, blue, and yellow buttons are the programs that you will use to make your StoryMaker video. Open them all. The red button is the Animation Now server. The green button is the client. The blue is the director, and the yellow is the timeline. When making your movie, you will ignore the Open Red Button tab and focus on the green, blue, and yellow buttons. The green button moves your character around as an animation. The blue button is where you will design your stage and/or layout. And the yellow button helps you to put audio, visual, and animations all together. Before you begin, create a folder to store your file and movies in. Click on the folder icon. Click on the desktop and then your teacher's name. Once you're in your teacher's folder, right-click and choose New Folder. Name the folder with your first and last name. This is where you'll be saving all of your files. You can see that I have further files within my larger file. This helps me to keep organized. If you've set up your file, open all four tabs for the StoryMaker animation software. I like to minimize the tabs that I'm not using to reduce screen clutter. In the blue tab, the director tab, you will create the stage, background, lighting, and characters for your video. As you can see, someone else has already started a video, so you want to create a new one for yourself. Go to the library and click New. Title it something relevant and easy to remember. To title it, click back to stage and rename it in the stage properties in the upper right hand corner. Leave the rest of the settings alone. Next, click on Add Screen in the bottom left hand corner. This essentially creates a platform for your video. Be sure the timeline option is checked. This will link the screen to the yellow tab or your timeline tab for later use. Render with the computer that you are on and then choose NDI as your target. Later, when you create your camera, you will choose which camera to focus on. Next, click Add Camera. This will be your background. Be sure to check Timeline. Here you can have a solid color background, for example, a green screen. Or you can choose a picture for a background. If you want to add your own picture, go back to the library section and then click Add Images. Find the file you want to upload and click Open. Be sure that the file was originally saved with a good titled name to help you locate it in the list of background options later. Go back into Camera, click the button that says Solid Color and choose Image. Then click below and choose the image you want. Next, click Add Lights. Check Timeline and then choose the type of light that you want. Point lights are default, but once you create a character, you can play around with the other options to change how they are illuminated and how their shadows are cast upon the background. To move the light, you will left click and hold down with the mouse while moving it around. You can also do this in a more calculated manner by playing with the settings in the Transform tab. If there is ever a time when you make a mistake, you can always click Undo. Let's move on to characters before I play around with other light settings. Click Add Character. Make sure they are visible and added to your timeline. You can choose from an already uploaded character by choosing your model in the Rendering tab. There are other models, though, which can be downloaded off of the StoryMaker website. If you go to the website, you can also download many different backgrounds from multiple points of view and perspectives to make your videos look much more professional and well thought out. To move your character, you can play around with the settings in the Transform tab, or you can click and hold down the middle scroll button on your mouse. Holding down the left click rotates your character on the Y-axis, while holding down the right click brings them closer or farther from the audience on the Z-axis. Go down to the Puppeteer tab and choose your computer as the client. Choose the joystick plugged into the computer, but leave the rest of the settings alone. The joystick allows you to move the character's head. In the Lip Sync tab, choose your computer as the voice, and then out speakers as the device. You can leave the rest of the settings alone for now. Now, let's go back to the lighting. You can see if there is no light, then the character is no longer visible. Obviously, we need light in order to see. As you can see, playing with the type of light and clicking and dragging the direction of the lights affects how your audience will see the character. You can change the color of the lights along with the intensity. Also, you can add multiple lights for various effects. Play with lighting until you feel it blends into and mirrors the environment of your background. You want your animation to be as lifelike as possible. Be sure to go to your screen and choose the camera, stage that you want to focus on. Also, you can click on the Gizmos tab to see a grid pattern. This will help ensure your character is level with the background for more realistic animation. To make your character move, go down to the Actions tab in the green Client program. If you click an action, you'll find that your character performs and mirrors that action. This will help you better understand the range of movements for your character that you can later use as animations in your timeline. Once you've built your stage, position your character, and organize the movements that you want to use in your storyboard, it's time to create a timeline. This will put all the pieces together. The timeline is the yellow tab. If any of the pieces of your video aren't showing up, be sure the timeline button is checked in all the stages of your director program. The first thing you want to do is add your audio file. If you haven't created one, you can do so in Audacity. You can also add a clip that you've downloaded from the internet. Right-click on your character's timeline and add speech. A final option is to record your voice while the timeline plays out. This might be difficult to manage, but it's certainly possible. Once you have your audio, you can add animated movements to bring your character to life. These will be labeled the same as the movements you experimented with in the green tab. Right-click in your character's timeline and click Clip. Here you can choose the actions available for your character. Click Play to see what it looks like. To play back only a certain section of your video, move the playback start and stop bar, or manually put in the key times that you would like to focus on. Clicking stop does not pause the playback, but rather restarts from where you set your playback start to start. You can click and drag the audio and actions to move them around within the timeline. Ideally, you want to choose actions that mirror and enhance the audio. Try to make it seem as lifelike as possible. When you are finished, click Export. You can choose a specific range to export or your whole timeline. Be sure the codec is MP4 H.264 video and that the Merge Audio into Video button is checked. The export will save your video under whatever name you originally titled your stage. The folder can be found under the C drive on your computer, the Animation Now folder, the Export folder, and then the folder you named your file or stage under. Once exported, you can leave the video as is or do further post-production editing in Adobe Premiere or DaVinci's Resolve. I hope that this tutorial was helpful. Thank you very much.